Those that don't know, I think Uber is done in California.
Yeah, because of the gig workers. They're trying to like make rights for gig workers and canceling people's jobs and livelihoods. Like first it was the journalists, right? The freelance writers. And now it's Uber and Lyft drivers. People who are just trying to make a little extra money on the weekend. And it's like, what are you doing?
So this was a Democratic proposal. It's called Assembly Bill 5. It limits gig workers. It was pushed heavily by unions. Right. And the journalists, man, when they started freaking out, I was right away. I was like, I can't hire contractors in California. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, good to know. I mean, you can, but like once or twice. Basically, I think journalists can only write 35 times, but some of these contractors have multiple contracts. This makes sense. Like the way I explain it is, let's say you like to pick up pieces of wood on the beach and whittle it into a little boat. You did that work, and then you say, I say to you, Lydia, I have this little Tim, this little man.
Look, it's adorable. It's a little me. But yeah, he's really cute.
And I have made such art, I would like to sell it to you.
Okay.
And the state says, you can't do that because you're not an employee.
Oh.
That's what AB 5 basically is doing now. If I write something and want to sell it to a company, I can't now. The state is telling me I can't literally sell a good. It gets complicated now when it comes to Uber. The way Uber and Lyft essentially was working was that you do your thing, man. We'll just connect you with people.
Right.
Well,
which is fantastic.
A judge ruled that Uber has to have all the people be employees. And so I guess Uber said this, right? They were like,
I think it was Uber.
If you don't rethink this, California, we will shut down Uber in the entire state.
Yep.
Talk about a state with bad leadership burning itself to the ground. I was talking to a friend in LA who said it's worse than it's ever been.
Yeah, I was talking to a friend in Fresno who said the exact same thing.
Garbage is everywhere.
Dude, violence.
Yeah.
You can witness anything you like on your front, you know, your front porch. There's so, no.
This brings me back to like the media bias. I wonder like how many of you listening or watching live in a rural area or a suburban area?
I'd be curious to know.
Yeah, because we're in the suburbs. So we don't see what's going on in the big cities. Not, I mean, we're not going to go there.
Nope, I'm good.
Yeah, I don't want to go there. But I was reading an article about New York for one, mass exodus.
Mm-hmm.
The moving companies are straight up like, it's moving day and we're overwhelmed and overbooked to move people out of New York City.
Yep.
But I was reading from other people who said that the city really is barren, like Manhattan especially, because there's no stores.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I kind of want to see it.
Yeah.
Empty streets.
Well, that would have been kind of like driving across California with absolutely no one else on the street. It was surreal when we were driving through LA. The streets were open, wide open.
Yeah.
It was rush freaking hour. It was 5 p.m. and there was no one on the road. And I felt like it was in a zombie movie. It was so strange. And then when I went to Philly a couple weeks ago, and I don't know if it was because of coronavirus or because Philly's a dump. But there was garbage everywhere. Like it was piled on the street corners. I saw a rat. I saw my first rat in Philadelphia. I was like, this is wonderful. I'm really glad to be here. This is very enriching.
Get out of the cities.
Dude, yeah. Like who would stay there? And I walked past these really, really nice apartments. I was like, I wonder how much these apartments cost to rent, because right in front of them, whoops, bumped my mic. There's this huge like wall of garbage and just literally rats running through it. And I was like,
oh, dude,
I would never live here.
The rats can't get food anymore because there's no scraps.
That's right.
So they're coming out and hunting
during the day. Dude.
I saw, like, I read something about like somebody getting chased by rats, I think.
Oh my gosh.
Maybe this was not real.
I hope not.
Like, you gotta Google it. Fact check me on this one. But I remember seeing like a tweet where they were talking about how in all of these cities, because there's no food anymore, the rats are starting to starve. So they're coming out desperate and they're going on hunts in packs. Yep.
Yeah.
And do you see the rat war?
No.
Yeah, there's like rat gang wars because they fight over food.
That sounds right.
Remember the baboon gang war?
Yes.
It was baboons, right?
Yeah, yeah, because there were no more tourists.
Yep.
Yeah, and they would flock out into the street. And just,
man.
Oh, man.
We've created like, I don't know, what do you call that?
Animal dystopia?
It's like in our wake as human civilization, we have created dependent subclass like communities.
Pigeons and rats
and
these monkeys overseas and
You know what's always like kind of tripped me out? Pigeons are literally our garbage turning into living things and flying away.
That is a horrible.
Like if, yeah, if I told somebody like in America, our garbage grows wings and flies away, people would be like, what are you talking about? Hear me out. A guy's walking down the street. He's got a cheeseburger in his hand and he slams it on the ground because he's lazy. And, you know, and now there's festering food. A pigeon swoops down. They all eat it. Mm-hmm. That food breaks it down in their bellies, turns into eggs and more pigeons.
Yeah.
Our garbage literally gets converted into birds.
That's interesting.
And then our garbage flies away.
And then comes back to pester us.
I mean, not really. Pigeons kind of, well, they poop on stuff.
Yeah.
But have you ever seen a baby pigeon?
They're so ugly.
You've never seen one, have you?
No. Well, I haven't seen one.
You Googled one.
Yeah, right. I did Google one because they're really freaking weird looking.
I think it is a privilege. I think it is a privilege that our garbage flies away. Could you imagine if there were no pigeons? Garbage everywhere just rotting in the streets.
That's true.
The pigeons clean it up and they leave. But yeah, so now because there's no people, the pigeons are flying off.
Yeah.
That's easy for them.
Right.
But the rats have nowhere to go. They're coming out of the ground. They're coming out in packs. You know what, man? We can complain about Antifa and the far left all day and night, but you know what really scare me? Like, if I see an Antifa guy, I know there's certain limits to what they've done and what they can do. If I see a far right guy, like, I'll avoid them both. I mean, far right is in, like, you know, the colloquial, like the real extremist, whatever. If I see an extremist, I don't care what their political ideology is. I'll go the other way. I'm in my own business. I see a large group of rats, like, running around ravenous. I'm running full speed.
Yeah, seriously.
Because you get bit, you get rabies.
Yep.
I don't
you
know,
get
maybe.
All sorts of illnesses.
Yeah.
What was it? Okay, the bubonic plague was carried by rats. I'm just going to
Well, that was the
that
fleas, wasn't it?
Yeah, so the fleas on the rats. Okay. So if you touch a rat, obviously you're in deep doo-doo.
But rabies, man. I mean, I don't want to end up like Joe Jorgensen.
That's, you know? I was just going to say, you don't want to get bitten by a bat. We're supposed to be the ones biting the bats, not vice versa.
That was a crazy thing. Did you guys see this? Joe Jorgensen, she's a libertarian candidate. She got bit by a bat. Had to get a
she had to go get shots, like a series of shots. Yeah.
Yeah. I hope she's okay. I really mean it. I mean, this is like a crazy thing to happen. Look, you know, when I see stories like this, I can't help but laugh.
Yeah.
At the absurdity of it.
Don't you have to wonder what she was doing to get bit by a bat? Like, she wasn't exactly on stage like Ozzy Osbourne trying to bite the bat. And the bat was just like, oh my gosh, I need self-defense. She was probably just like, I don't know, cleaning her attic or something. It's so weird to me. I was like, how do you get bitten by a bat? That's kind of cool.
I've seen a bat one time out here.
Uh-huh.
So we've got a deck. Like, you can go on and it's like, you know, it's elevated. And I've seen, like, they're kind of weird when you see them.
They're birds at first.
But they fly weird.
It's dark.
They
flop
around.
Yeah.
Kind of weird. And if they bite you, you gotta get a bunch of shots in your stomach or something.
Yeah.
Is that what happens?
Those are the rabies shots.
Have you ever seen that happen?
I have not seen that happen.
Do you know how it works?
Yeah. So I didn't work in a doctor's office. I would see the nurses administer some of the shots. I mean, and you would go and get shots from the nurses, charge nurse and doctors who were there. But I never saw a rabies shot administered. Some of them you got to get in your butt. Sounds horrible. No, not rabies. Rabies is the stomach, which...
Your stomach.
Oh, also awful.
We're like into your stomach.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Like literally, not like your belly.
I don't think
into
the organ. I think it's into the adipose tissue there, as far as I know. So your belly fat, I believe. Fact check me on this one.
Man,
because
I'm glad we have these vaccines, dude. Rabies is scary.
I am too, but
people think it's like, they think it's like a zombie thing. It's not.
No, that'll mess you up.
You can't swallow. You keep spitting. You start convulsing.
I think it dehydrates you really bad.
Yeah, because you can't swallow.
Yeah.
And then you get foaming at the mouth.
Mm-hmm.
You do not want to get bit by a rat, man.
Don't get bit by a rat either. We'll turn you into a libertarian.
Well, for most of you, you probably know. We'll mention this. Crowder got his money back.
He did. Yeah, this is really cool.
YouTube will let Steven Crowder run ads after a year-long suspension for harassment.
Ooh.
I think that's BS. I don't think he actually got suspended for harassment. I think they said he straight up, he didn't break any rules, didn't they?
Well, the thing with Carlos, right? Carlos Maza,
yeah.
I think is what they're considering harassment or whatever. So it sounds like classic YouTube nonsense. I don't really know if it was actual harassment or it was just YouTube's interpretation.
You know what I think?
Hmm.
I think they were like, we have no choice because of the media wave to do something, but don't worry, we'll figure it out.
Well, I remember thinking at the time, I was like, there's so much pressure on them to do something. Kind of like they're trying to exert pressure on Facebook right now. They have to do something. So they're probably going to like suspend him or whatever. And they sure did for a whole year, dude. So why did they decide to give him his ads back?
They were always reviewing him. That's
the
my
whole time?
My understanding is that he had to clean up his act.
Uh-huh.
There were certain things he couldn't have on the show, but they would reinstate him. And it's because it is interesting. He didn't break any rules, but they were like, it's a rock and a hard place.
Yeah.
I think they should have stood firm, but there's always, there is a legitimate challenge when like, if somebody came to me and said, we are going to shut down your entire business completely, you know, unless you do one small thing, you'll find a lot of people would say yes to it. Like for me, for instance, I won't say the name of the creepy whistleblower guy because right. they'll delete the stream instantly. And for me, I have my line.
Well, we like talking to people, so we're not. We're
well, no, like, I'll tell you what, like, I cannot say someone's name. I'm like, whatever.
Right.
But, like, you know, when it came to, I did a segment on masks and, like, hydroxychloroquine and stuff. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, if they ban me, they ban me. Like, I swear to God, like, I have my limits. If the news is legit and it's certified and we've got doctors, I'm saying it. You know what I mean? And maybe they'll give me the X. But I think what's happening is YouTube is saying, listen, man, everybody will lose their monetization in an adpocalypse unless we do something. So you can jump on the grenade or adpocalypse.
Right.
And I think YouTube said, you know, that's what we're going to go for. I completely disagree with this, with doing these things.
Right.
I think, you know, there are lines and limits. Like if I don't say a guy's name, I can still let you know that there is a name you can't say. You can Google this and it has to do with a CIA whistleblower mm-hmm. and Ukraine. And, you know, now you'll find the person.
Yep.
And you can then investigate yourself. If I get myself banned, I can't tell you that. However, I will never withhold vital and important news, even if it means the end. YouTube deciding I can sacrifice an individual because we're scared for the collective, to me, is how you get into authoritarianism.
Yeah.
So Crowder, who broke no rules, gets negatively impacted, and I'm not okay with it.
Yeah, what's that saying? You got to break a few eggs to make an omelet. You're willing to sacrifice a few people to the greater good.
What is it, like a deontological philosophy versus...
I think that's what it is, but utilitarian. I haven't really gotten into that very
yeah,
much.
Yeah, like I think utilitarian is like the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few versus deontological, where it's like you must protect the individual because the there is no collective without an individual.
Yeah, I'm toward the end of that spectrum.
I think YouTube was wrong in this. Yeah. I think Crowder broke no rules, and if they came to me and said there's an adpocalypse because of what Crowder did, I'd be like, well, Crowder didn't do anything wrong, so that's your responsibility. And well, you're going to lose ad revenue now. I'd be like, yeah, that's too bad, isn't it? I would not support a negative action against someone who did no wrong to benefit myself. YouTube should have absolutely stood their ground and said, he didn't break any rules. Sorry. Yeah.
You're stronger than YouTube, I think. They're being kind of weak.
Hopefully. Thanks for checking out this clip from the Timcast IRL podcast. We do the show live Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. If you want to catch the full show, tune into this channel, subscribe, hit the like button, or check us out on iTunes and Spotify, and we will soon have this podcast up for free on all podcast platforms. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you all in the next episode.